Right. Yes. That there is Spyro 3 Black Label. I recently found Spyro 1 as a Scandinavian version, and this third one, not the second one, unfortunately. But this Black Label one is a Scandinavian, and I've never played this before. Until getting it, I have played a few levels, and that's that. But I have heard about some glitches that affect even the first PAL copies too. You know, I tried to do the speedway glitch. I found quite accurate instructions on how to do it, and I couldn't trigger it. Maybe I still did something wrong, or my internet has lied to me, as I found a 1.0 PAL rip. It did match my disk here, and some platinum rips apparently, which were 1.1, and I concluded that my disk here, this is the original 1.0 version of the game, and either the glitch is not happening how do I say it, the glitch does not happen at the place I tried that. I tried the very first speedway. I'm not very far anyway. It happens in less places, or it doesn't happen at all. Yes. Or I just have gotten lucky. anyway, there I found a person selling this game. It was another copy, Scandinavian. It did not have the manual, but I noticed that the disc said, let's see, can we get closer? No. The disc said here, SCSI 02835, and there was a hashtag sign, and this does not have it. So I asked the person selling the other thing some things, such as when is data dated and all that, last modified. And what he then said did match those platinum rips I got. So I've heard someone report that there is not glitchy black labels in US. And what I experienced recently seems to confirm that such case happens with PAL. There's fixed black label copies too. I got this recently. It's naturally 1.1. It's a Scandinavian 2. But yeah, this is like driver 2 situation. I have no idea why they did an update to that game. I haven't encountered anything too bad. It has 1.0, the original black label, then updated 1.1 as a black label. That also made it to the platinum pressings way later and to the limited edition. This is such case, except this has nothing different. The other example had a different manual things between all three. 1.0 had incomplete one, 1.1 had an added slip, and with Platinum the information is added to the manual itself. I did check these manuals in both of these are the same, so I'd rather have the 1.1 as a black label instead of Platinum. If I ever get it, I'll get rid of this one. But yes, there exists a black label 1.1s here too. And I did check the saves are indeed compatible with each other. But I'm going to play the game as much as I can with this disc. I'll post some first impressions later on. But it's an interesting situation, really. But yeah, that's if you live in the PAL region, you know which version you get as a black label if you look at the disc, if you see the hashtag pound sign, whatever you wanna call it. It's 1.1. If it doesn't have it, then it's the original 1.0. Which, from my experience, is not as buggy as people say, but who knows. Oh yeah, need to check the Crash Bash demo, if it's dated any different. The folder is dated later with this one. So I need to check that. But I'll leave the Platinum for now. Interesting things. You know, this proves that not just Platinums or Greatest Hits can be 1.1s, it can be the black label too. There's two such cases I know, and two PS1 games in my game collection that I know that have this kind of thing. Driver 2 and Spyro 3 both have updated copies before the Platinum release. So I don't like that people say that 1.1 is Platinum or Greatest Hits only or something. That's not true, obviously. Yeah, this one was dated 29th of 9th 2000, and the other 1.1 is dated 24th of 10th 2000. It's about a month. That's different. With Driver 2, it's half a month between them two revisions. But yeah, I'll go now. This rant has reached too long time. Goodbye, sir.